Hello, I'm Kira from Kronos, where we are passionate about mentoring, and today we are going to be talking about three of the most common mistakes that we see in mentoring programs. The first mistake we see is making mentoring an initiative without making it a priority. This is really important because you might see, you know, we see a lot of organizations that come to us and they want to do mentoring and they like the idea of mentoring, but they haven't allocated enough resources to really make it thrive and succeed. So if you're planning a mentoring initiative for your organization, make sure you know who's going to be setting it up, making key decisions around the program strategy, developing content if that needs to happen, and deploying it and running it day to day, and make sure that you've considered how much time to allocate for that person. Sometimes we see people come to us who have, you know, full-time jobs and are expected to get a mentoring program out the door as well, and that's a surefire way to see the mentoring program struggle to get off the ground successfully and potentially not have enough, you know, day-to-day hands-on support to make it succeed in the long term. Number two is not having active executive involvement. You've probably heard it's very important to have executive buy-in, and this is true, but it's also important that that executive is really engaged in, you know, program oversight. What we see when that happens is that the program really has an ambassador at the senior level to become and remain an organizational priority. And that's the best way to really integrate mentoring into the organization. And it really does trickle down and impact everything about the program down to the level of whether people feel they can really spend time on mentoring. Number three is trying to create a self-driven mentoring program before people are really ready for it. A self-driven mentoring program is one where people are responsible for joining the mentoring program, finding their own mentor, and creating their own path, you know, of success in mentoring. This can result in pretty low adoption of mentoring if the organization is not already a very self-driven culture. But getting them there sometimes means providing extra guidance and shepherding them through that process, rather than just kind of pushing a mentoring program out the door and hoping people come and are interested. So that can involve a lot of active marketing for the program, a lot of training and education opportunities to make sure that mentees are equipped to sort of drive productive mentoring relationships and that they understand what's expected of them. And it could also involve assisting people in finding the right mentor for them, maybe even assigning mentors at first while you build a strong mentoring and learning culture. So these are our three most common mistakes that we see. Would love to hear what challenges you have experienced in mentoring yourself. Please, you know, leave a comment below, or you can connect with us on Twitter @Kronos Software.